What if colorful is the best way to go forward? I guess Niki de Saint Phalle made that choice. She's best known for her giant nanas you see here. To me, they never looked like art, just simple colorful sculptures, until I visited an exhibition of her artwork and started to pay attention. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, inspiring you to embrace the magic of making art. At first, I thought it would be easy to draw a Nana figure on paper, but I failed miserably. So I take a different route and take a picture of one of her Nanas and put a grid over it. I multiply the size, copy the grid on a bigger 100 by 65 cm sheet and draw the contours again. I cut out the giant drawn Nana and copy her outline on a new sheet. And run into my first hurdle. How will I dress my Nana? Looking at the artwork of Niki de Saint Phalle, I see she often used a one-piece swimsuit, and all these variations give me the freedom to do whatever. She highlighted specific body parts, but I decided to use two more modest balls to look for the right position to draw them. But zooming in, I also noticed she often used mosaic techniques. So for my painting course, I decided to give them, besides paint, the option to use paper collage and bring a number of these colorful magazines. Here you see the beginning of their artwork. It's interesting to see they all start in a different way. Before I continue, I want to talk about these early artworks, shooting paintings by Niki de Saint Phalle, collages of found objects and plastic packages of paint all covered with white plaster. The actual shooting was done as a performance act. By shooting at them with a rifle, she caused cascades of brightly colored paint to pour down over the cluttered surfaces of the artwork. Link up here in case you'd like to know more. I will not use a rifle, but I take a slightly different route from the participants, so I turn over our plastic bin and gather some items to use in my Nana painting and come up with these. I often hear people say, also at my local painting course, art materials are so expensive. I will dive into the money issue in a future video, but for now I want to see if I can avoid paint altogether. Here's some items from our waste paper bin. In a minute I will also reveal a seasonal material. The first stage is the swimsuit, and I start by placing these jar lids. No matter what materials I use, color combinations and contrast will always be a part of the artistic process. So because of the color of the jar lids, I need a contrasting color to expand the size of the circles. So this orange one as a background, and later the green color for the other. I will not show every detail because it will take too much time, but I will show the item before I will use parts of it. A value pack of fruit biscuits has this nice white line dividing two colors. I cut and glue away all the words on it to get a clear colored strip. I don't like the amount of plastics that is used in our society and prefer to buy without, but in this moment the colorful garbage is nice. For the next item, the product name is too big to get rid of, so I decide to use it as is. Actually, it looks way more fun like this. The painting will become a treasure hunt for anyone looking at it. What products and brands are used? The process is the same for any new item, so I use a croissant package, a box of tacos, a tea bag box, a brown paper bag, and the front of a magazine the participants used. The swimsuit is finished and we go back to the artwork of Niki de Saint Phalle to especially look at the color of the Nana bodies. Here a blue one, and a number of other colors. Basically, I can take any color I want. I will go for blue, because I feel blue about the fact that money can be an issue for people to keep them from being creative. Here's some Easter eggs, left over from Easter a week ago. These wrappers have a nice polka dot pattern. And the eggs still taste delicious. It's April, and just this week I put the last seeds into the bird feeder. I take the blue part of the plastic bag, and there's the other leg. Over to these dreaded blue envelopes of our Dutch Tax and Customs Administration. This week they made us smile because of a tax return. While doing the head and arms, I can't help to think of objectification. It puzzles me that Niki de Saint Phalle, a woman and an artist in the 60s and 70s, would create voluptuous nanas without recognizable faces and hands, as if the female body is more important than the female person in it. As you can see, stage 2, the body is completed. Back to the participants and how they proceed, because each one translates the same exercise in their own way. Like here, a diversity of paint colors, an old credit card, and there she goes, creating colorful legs and arms. Or here, a colorful collage and black paint for the legs. Some go fast, some take their time, or don't finish in time, what is also okay. Over to stage 3 for me. I have some pieces of cardboard, a box and a tray for cans, tubes from toilet paper rolls, I cut the tube in small slices. They don't come out nicely round, unfortunately, but for me they represent bubbles, tunnels or islands or whatever. Life can be full of challenges, and a light at the end of a tunnel can be nice, or a bubble to escape into. The cardboard from a tray of cans has a white and a brown side. Both are interesting, just as the box with pastel colored sides I will use later on. I hesitated a long time to make this video because of the way she shaped the nanas and the subject of objectification. But I know she made her colorful artworks to bring joy. So what if the nanas of Niki de Saint Phalle don't represent women? What if the nanas were just the shape that represents in the best way her ideas of pure joy? Colorful, free, dancing, feminine looking bodies? Finding the right shape for your artwork can start by investigating your options in a simple way. Interested? Click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.